Interviewee number 35.
Mr. McConkey, how does your past or current experience prepare you for the Deputy Director of Administration position for the City of Richmond?
Well, most of my experience is in administrative functions such as budgeting, accounting, personnel, the different aspects of what your job is. The last 8 years I've been city manager and the finance director for the city of Cary. And most of that job deals with the same type of things that your job does. Before that, of course, I've been city manager in different locations and the same type of thing. I've had as many as 65 people work for me.
Is that it? You just sort of ended real.
Well, that's sort of a, yeah, no.
Okay.
What do you consider your greatest accomplishment in your current or past position?
Usually say I'm ready, but now I'm not really ready. I haven't prepared to answer questions, so I have to think about them. Usually by the time I get to the interview, I've thought of the questions and I've already thought of the answers. Let's see, what was your question again, lady?
What do you consider your greatest accomplishment in your current or past position?
Well, when I first became finance director in Cary, my staff and I sat down and worked out a 5-year improvement plan, and we decided the major goals and objectives. What?
You're saying too much.
Well, that's the top thing that I'm looking for.
Okay.
We were trying to set a 5-year goals and objectives. You know what I was talking about?
Mm-hmm. It's harder to do with me than it is
with somebody. Yeah, I think she's probably going to ask the questions and she's not going to say anything. You mean like that?
They might do something to try to make you
ask. Probably before she starts, maybe. But that is after she starts. Part of those goals and objectives were to increase the bond rating with Standard & Poor's and Moody's from a AA to from a single A, from an A- to a AA. We were able to accomplish all the different goals and objectives that we set, including computerizing the accounting and financial systems, which was important to us. A lot of those were manual at the time.
The worst thing is, you can't tell when you finished answering a question. you need to maybe say, in conclusion, I feel like that was probably my, repeat the question. That was probably my greatest accomplishment. Describe your management style.
Done this question before. Well, I'm real easygoing. I believe in letting the employees do their work without a lot of interference from the supervisors, from the managers. I want to know what's going on at all times, that we hire the very best employees that are available, given whatever tools is necessary to do the job, give them as much training as we think is necessary to do the job, and then we tell them what it is that we want, very specifically, what we want them to accomplish. Then we let them do their own thing, essentially, with them giving us regular updates. But I'm not a screamer. I don't get upset when things aren't going exactly the way I want them to go. The communication part of management is one of the most important things one of the most important aspects is communication. People have a hard time doing what you want when they don't know what it is that you do want. So we have a very systemized communication where I meet with my supervisors every Monday morning, and then the supervisors go back and meet with their groups on Monday afternoons. And we not only tell them what's going on within the department, but also townwide. And the discussions are real broad, and we want to make sure that they understand everything that is going on.
What did I just recommend so that you could tell you were finished?
So I guess that's my style. My style would be one that is, what's a good word for that? I started to say laid back, but you don't want to say laid back. That would be a terrible thing to say. One that's easygoing, and also one that's based on real high quality communication.
What do you consider your weak point?
You're going to love this answer. I got this one from Lee, actually. I probably work too hard. I thought that was a great answer. Lee told me that's what he used with Peter Vine. I probably work too many hours and probably take too much upon myself, things that maybe I should pass off on to my supervisors. That's a question that the airport asked me, and that's the answer that I gave, except for it was a little more lengthy than that.
If you were offered this position, what would you do your first week on the job?
Get to know my employees and people that I have responsibility for, who they are, what their backgrounds are, what they do as far as job duties, their educational backgrounds and employment backgrounds. Sit down with them one-on-one and talk to them. What do they need? What do they expect from me? What I expect from them. Again, I think that's the first thing that needs to be done.
If you could be an archaeologist or an explorer, which would you be?
Be an explorer.
And why?
Being an archaeologist is passive. You're looking for something that's already happened, and being an explorer is active. You're going out and doing something maybe that no one else has done before. And that would be more of a challenge and be more fun, I believe.
Describe yourself in one word. Not two words, not a sentence, just one word.
I can't say good and bad or something like that.
That's three words.
That's a good question that really no one's ever asked me before, so I'd have to give that some thought.
And it might be different depending on the circumstances. I mean, to me, if you're doing this, you could say intimidated. And then, you know, you're not supposed to say anything else, but, or you could, you know, say interested, or you could say laid back, or hungry. I mean, you know. Ambitious, hardworking.
I don't know what a normal answer would be.
I think that's a stupid question. That's one Lou asks, and I think it's dumb because what does it tell you?
Well, how quick you are with an answer, I guess. I would probably have to say something like laid back, but again, that's. You probably don't want to say that to a prospective employer because that denotes lazy also, where it's really not meant to be that way. It's just easygoing, I guess.
What shirt? You're just gonna wear a blue shirt. This is Gary McConkie, interviewee number 2. Mr. McConkie, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I grew up in Tennessee, and after graduating from high school, I spent 4 years in the Navy as an electrician. Got out of the Navy and went to East Tennessee State University. Graduated with a degree in political science and minors in accounting and labor relations. That's going to be real hard to do, and doing that is just so natural for me.
Well, it's bad. No. Go ahead. Continue, sir. You graduated with a degree in political science and minor in labor relations.
After graduation, my wife and I moved to Memphis, and I got a job with the city of Memphis in the personnel department, and I was going to graduate school at night in the MPA program and then switched to the MBA program. Right before I graduated, I had an opportunity to be city manager in Hickman, Kentucky, and since that's what I've always wanted to do, work in city government and be a city manager, I took the opportunity when it came. Since that time, I've been city manager in Hickman, city manager in Jefferson City, Tennessee, and the last 8 years I've been a finance director in Cary, North Carolina. I have 2 children, teach Sunday school, coach Little League baseball, and my hobby is woodworking.
Okay. Why did you apply for this position?
Well, when I saw it advertised, it was the type of thing that I was looking for. Cary is an extremely attractive place to work, a nice place to live, a good job. But the town is smaller than what I was really looking for. Richmond has a lot of name recognition. Career-wise, people know where Richmond is. They don't know where Cary is. It's the type of work also that I'm interested in doing and that I'm good at.
Why should we choose you for this position?
Well, I think I have all the qualifications that you're looking for in this job, and I'm also very hardworking, very dedicated to whoever it is that I'm working for. I give whatever effort is necessary to get the job done. I'm a good manager, a good administrator. That pretty much sums up why I think I'm the best person for this job.
What do you consider your most interesting quality?
The length of my penis.
I knew you'd say that. I did. I knew if I asked something like that, that's the kind of answer you'd give me. You're still not doing what I told you, though. You're not ending your questions by repeating what the question was.
Actually, you wanted me to start, too, that.
You really should.
What was the question again? Read that last.
What do you consider your most interesting quality?
My most interesting quality, probably just the fact that I'm very easygoing and have a very good sense of humor. That's probably the way I'm most interesting.
Okay. You probably ought to say you could. You want me to say more? You want me to ask you any more?
Go! This is Kelly the cat.
Hello. This is Halloween, October 1990, October the 31st. And I'm now a kitty, and we had 2 people come to our house this month. A cowgirl, which is Melissa Duncan, and a pirate, which I don't know who he is, and his little brother. And my brother's a look. and he's shining lights on the camera. And my daddy's behind the camera, and my mommy doesn't know what to be, so she's inside right now. And here are my pumpkins.
What are their names? Thank you, and goodbye.
I am the Wolf Man. Actually, I'm Brett. Pretty good, huh? Well,
not very fierce. Is that the best you can do?
Ah! Yeah, good. Cool. All right. Kelly named the pumpkins already. Pumpkins is hairy, and that's scary.
And that's
his cousin Daddy. And well, Kelly made up the names. I carved them all. Cool. I like them too. Well, we're gonna go Halloween.
Trick-or-treating.
Whatever you call it.
Trick-or-treating.
I forget.
Trick-or-treating.
Yeah, gross. What is that? I just put my hand on something here and it's fine. We're about to go trick-or-treating. And we hope we get all the candy in the neighborhood. Whatever. Goodbye!
November 3rd. Who cares?
I'm not lying. I've been watching you in the middle of the night. It's 12 to 10. I'm just getting it in.
It is 9.
It's 2. Daddy, look. How can I ever say so?
Children did my hair. I think they're both gifted, don't you?
First of all, I didn't tell
Britt did my hair. Kelly did my makeup.
I raised lunch from some bunch.
Nice rosy glow to my cheeks and my nose. She thinks I can be Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer. Britt thinks I look like a little Jamaican honey. Britt said that they should strip me naked and put me outside to howl at the wolves. I asked
you need to say that again. You got it all wrong. Strippy duck,
Brent
buck
said
naked.
They should strip me buck naked and put me outside to howl at the moon.
Better.
Mommy, say this.
Do you think I should do that? Lovely.
He was acquitted, even though the government had produced a signed confession. When it was over, the jury...
No, Becky, take two.
I think my daughter might grow up to be a face maker, and my son might be a hairdresser. Can't you just see Brent as a hairdresser?
A bribe is a criminal act. Am I right or wrong? I was acquitted of criminal
action. Mommy, I think you should be. You should have been.
And I'd have been whistling in the air.
That's what she gets.
Thank you. Thank you. This is my first show, really, except for when I was like 4 or 5, and I did one for my mom. So I'm not too sure about this song.
With you for 2 days, and I'm cold and tired. Well, where's the surprise you brought me here to see?
Here's Rudolph, boys. Somebody snitched on me.
sunny. Next year I'll be going straight. Next year I'll be good, just wait. I'd start now, but it's too late. Somebody... Who's that coming down the chimney with a bag over his shoulder? It's him! It's him! I thought he wasn't coming!
Where's the silverware, little boy?
In the dining room, like I told you!
And the jewelry?
Same place as last time. How about my cup?
The usual?
The usual. Join me on the chorus, okay?
Why not?
I'm getting Latin for Christmas. Mommy and Daddy are mad. I'm getting Latin for Christmas. Cause I ain't been nothing but bad. Have a good season?
Excellent.
Open this one tonight. It sounds like a Game Boy.
That's a Game Boy.
Stand behind Brent. Instead of being in front of him.
Clothes, underwear.
We're at Brent's about 8 times.
It's those underwear.
Hey, some newest clothes.
Everyone, it is clothes.
Hey, Brent, fix the box, man. Don't tear the box.
Yeah, keep it used.
Ding, ding, ding.
That's not clothes.
Oh. Ladies and gentlemen.
And I brought it over.
Oh, dude. He got it.
Praise God.
Mario.
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 It doesn't open, it slides out, Brent. Don't mess up the thing.
That's what I just said. Gotta get
Did
that
you get it?
Skull.
Be careful. Don't slide there on strawberry. I'll leave him in there.
No.
It's a mess. You need to take out the bad dude.
Bad dude.
You might let me do it, Brent.
Bad dude. Second time I played that game,
Brent,
I'll
can
beat
I open
it.
This, please? Please?
No.
It's my birthday
can
present.
Can I please open this?
No.
No.
Birthday present. Why would I let you open my birthday present? And this,
Daryl Strawberry, he got traded.
That's his rookie card.
No, he traded to the Los Angeles Dodgers.
That's his rookie card.
It's rookie?
Stop!
It's something you need to
get. Stop, Kelly!
It's my card!
I don't care.
I'll pay you for that.
Y'all scared me with this, Dad. Did you intend on me telling Mom?
No, stupid. I took you in there to tell you to act like you liked it. What a... doofus.
I was trying to act like he liked it, and then he looked on the back of it.
I know, I went like this, there. I was gonna go. Open it, Mike. Open the other one. Brent, open the other one.
Hey, Brian.
I don't know.
Can I open it, please?
No, it's my birthday present. Why would I?
Mike!
Ah, God.
Well, I didn't even touch your head.
Mike, I'm gonna have to Mike, I'm gonna kick your ankle.
You know the caption along with my husband?
Okay.
We'll have to do the whole party over.
I think we'll be very careful. That is a very special.
Let me look at it.
Okay. I'm gonna open it next to my best friend who's looking in a book. Mike, you can trade this little bow off.
No, let me do one rip.
All right, one rip. Don't. All right, that's good.
I did it!
All right, everybody gets a rip.
Everybody gets a rip.
But
I turned
down the stuff on the table.
Brent's birthday party, 1990.
Bring it back.
What a group. Makes the rules as he goes along.
I'm gonna get it.
That's Brent's favorite play.
Thanksgiving, November the 22nd, 1990. I have been in here cooking, as you can see. Me and Mama Connie have been cooking. We've got a turkey. We've got things ready to bake. We got rolls sitting here raising. We've got potatoes in the pan. We're now waiting on Woody and Cassie and Katie to arrive. See, we've got the dishes ready and set to go. We got the table ready. I've been inside cooking. Bobby, Bob, and Brent have been shooting some basketball. Yep, there was Brent. Oh, that was Bobby Bob. Oh, missed again. All right. Okay, good shot, guys. All right, for Bobby Bob. Can he make it?
No.
And he gets the layup. Good shot. Now Gary's busy watching TV on this Thanksgiving Day. Right now I'm not sure what he's watching.
Gatlinburg,
we have a scenic trail. About Gatlinburg, is it today or is it?
Anybody coming into Gatlinburg should be sure to get onto the Over Gatlinburg tram and ride up to the top and visit some of those places.
You having a nice, restful day? Gary? Ellie is watching some TV in Brent's room. Right now she's bouncing. On the tram. Say Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Cooking and slaving. You can see what she's doing.
I got codenamed the robot.
I'm sorry. She told right. us. We got the windows open.
This was Ever Crouch's Road. It's a Pendleton.
His road?
They cost about $75.
So it's on the road again?
It's on the road again.
On the road again.
It's on my body. Oh, baby.
Are you having a nice Thanksgiving?
Yes, real nice. I am. But I said I have done everything. I cooked the toast turkey. I made the rolls. I made the gravy.
So that's why we invited you. That's why we invited her, isn't it, kids? Okay.
Finally here.
Can we eat now?
We thought they would never get here. Gary says, can we eat now?
Yes, I'm driving.
Hi.
Hi.
Hello.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving.
You all have eaten, haven't you? Because we've already
eaten. Oh, good. I figured that.
Mama, Connie.
I have lots of food.
Are you?
I have lots of food. Well, I can go.
Oh, goodness sakes. I'm so glad y'all got here.
Hi, Katie.
Good to see you.
Hi, Kelly. How are you? You've grown even more. Hi, Bill.
I'll get her in the hand.
You get out of the bathroom so the adults can eat.
Oh, she made the sound of the toilet flushing.
Oh, there he is.
One day this old lady was...
For this day, we thank thee for life, and for the many blessings that thou hast bestowed upon us, both those that were joyful and also those that were some problems to us. And we pray that those that were problems have strengthened our faith. We thank thee and ask thee to be with us in all we do. Help us in the things that we go about, that we undertake. Be with our families and the others who are far from home in our family this day. And we ask to guide and direct us, and may we use this food for the strengthening of our body. And these things we pray in Christ's name. Amen.
Sure. After dinner on Thanksgiving Day.
Kids haven't come back,
Becky? No.
Are they safe?
Oh.
You have me enough.
See her pretty outfit?
Yeah, Becky gave me this for my birthday. 6 to 9 years old and dressing like a clown.
We've been for a walk.
We're only going for an hour and a half.
Did you jump on the trampoline?
Yeah.
Is anybody down there?
Well, at first when we got there, Nathaniel was there and we said, do you think we could jump? And he said, yeah. And so we jumped a little bit and then Joey came and we played around.
And then he started going.
Do that again, Woody. Do that again.
Me and her.
Me and her. You two. No. Yeah, come on. All you gotta do is pass it to me. Come here, Dad.
All right.
Here, watch.
Have an adult against them. Oh. All right, yay! Hey, you better guard Woody.
Oh no!
You can't hold my hand.
her a try.
Yeah, give her a try.
Right up there. I like to turn it on the square.
Ah, it's Trinity! Oh, I'm pooped.
I don't know.
Jack! Oh, now get it! Get the rebound!
Oh,
he's got it. Ah, oh, 42,
Peyton. I like it. Now, what are we supposed to
You're
do?
You're just supposed to try to guess which answer you think she would say.
Now, this is what? I'm sorry. This is what Katie said?
Yeah. She has to marry one of these people. Which one of them do you think she would marry? Michael J. Fox? Fred Savage,
Kirk Cameron.
Kirk Cameron.
Fred Savage.
I'd say Kirk Cameron.
Well, we could just score y'all here. Let's just
do
that.
Who do you say? Do we agree as a team or no?
No, we'll do different.
Probably Kirk Cameron.
Katie can't say yes or no, right? Yeah, not yet.
Not yet.
Okay.
Gary, you
going to
guess?
Michael J. Fox.
Okay, she picked Kirk Cameron. So Woody, Kathy know their dog.
Well, okay. I guess that's good.
If she was going to go out to dinner to a fast food restaurant, would she choose the Burger King?
Kitchen, Burger King or McDonald's?
What was the other one?
Kentucky Fried Chicken, Burger King, or McDonald's?
Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Burger King.
I'll say Kentucky Fried Chicken too.
You don't know if you got it.
I don't.
Okay.
She picked Kentucky Fried Chicken.
So Connie and Cassie got
burned,
that one right.
She got burned down on Burger King going to Florida. Who
not
Woody.
Oh, I had Hardee's pizza puff, and
okay.
It was not good.
Katie's going to read a book. Would she rather read a biography, a mystery, or a love story?
Mystery.
Huh.
Love story.
I like
a mystery.
I pick a biography. Well, you might know, but no, I'm out of it here.
Okay, she's going to get a nightgown. Would she rather have a nightgown that had teddy bears on it, rainbows on it, or flowers on it?
Rainbows.
Teddy
bears. Why are teddy bears?
She got it.
She knows her kid.
I didn't hear the teddy bear part. I just heard rainbows.
Teddy bears, rainbows, and flowers.
Okay, I don't know my dog.
Okay, teddy bears was right, so Kathy got that one also. Okay, she's going to get a new car. Would she rather have
Ferrari,
a Porsche, a Maserati, or a Lamborghini?
Ferrari Testarossa.
Don't know what those cars are.
Well, she chose one.
I'll say Porsche.
Lamborghini.
Okay, I'd say Porsche too.
It's a
she
Porsche.
And
she said Porsche.
I want a Ferrari Testarossa, man. I want a Ferrari. Oh yeah, for Christmas, y'all.
Okay.
Ferrari Testarossa is really what I meant.
Okay, she's going overseas. Would she rather go to Spain,
Germany,
or
France?
I say Spain.
I'd
want to go to Gepari if I was Germany.
She
Mom's
got it.
Right. Spain.
Because she speaks Spanish.
And I hate Spanish.
Yeah, no,
I know. The reason I hadn't said that was because I knew you could.
But she hates French fries worse, so.
Okay, toothpaste.
Bubblegum, chocolate, or strawberry?
Which flavor would she choose? Bubblegum, chocolate, or strawberry?
I said
bubblegum.
Strawberry.
Strawberry.
Bubblegum. Kathy knows her.
My turn.
Okay, Kathy had 5 points, Mom had 3 points, and Woody had 3 points.
Cassie won.
Thanksgiving is over.
Like a rabbit.
Now they're getting ready to leave.
Yeah, it's not Thanksgiving. This is July. The temperature is 75 degrees.
Well, that is true.
Hey.
Wait a minute. I don't
remember.
I've got my pocket.
Darcy.
I'm
not
I didn't notice.
Get a picture of the catwalk. Get a picture of the catwalk.
We don't know whose cat this is.
One called Roy.
It's going to throw up on you.
I know.
It's going to bring on you.
I took the picture.
Did you find it?
Yeah, it was sitting in there. My pocketbook. I left my pocketbook.
Most of them were just grabbed. Well, let's see, and I hope one of them worked out for you guys.
Right. Yeah, why don't you get a dumb of wire someplace?
Wow, isn't that awesome? We didn't have to have nibbles. Where? Hey, Mom!
Oh, baby, grab my baby.
My kitty,
it is hard to believe that it is November the 25th.
Bye.
And it's as warm as it is. In the side yard by the trash cans. December the 13th, 1990. We're getting ready to go to Cary Elementary where Kelly is going to be singing with the other third graders in the Christmas program. We've had a good day. Gary is in Richmond at a job interview. And Becky, let's see if we can get this here. We'll just walk on around here. Becky won an award today with the Department of Public Information.
Ah, forgot. There's Kelly. What are you doing? Hey, Kelly. Whoops, can't move. That is not my sister. She is. Wave, Kelly! My sister is in the ring.
Good evening. Oh, I got your attention. I saw all these hands turn around. Can everybody hear me in the back? Please raise your hand if you... All right, thank you. I appreciate it. Welcome to the holiday program at Cary Elementary. The children have done a terrific job. You're going to enjoy every minute of it. Even though you're all crammed in this little room, I promise you it will be worth it. It's going to be tons of fun. We will have the Pledge of Allegiance. Will be done by Pack 201, Den 2 of the Cub Scouts. Child may bring those to school tomorrow. We hope to get the baskets together over the weekend and deliver them the first of next week. So if you have any extra canned goods, pasta.
Feeling the air, the sound of children everywhere. Thank you. By the a white bear and a red suit reindeer. It must be St. Nick. It must be jolly old St. Nick.
Kelly is serenading the neighbors, singing Christmas carols.
December the 21st. This is Christmas at the McConkey family. Anybody want to say anything?
Hey, dude.
All the women in here are talking about picking something out of their hair. I don't know what. Fleas or lice or something like that.
Yes. People that get these perms and they mix them.
Let's get a real close up. Margaret hates her hair.
Right, I do. And I like mine.
Okay, one of you. Who's first? Ethan? Let me get a good one. Wait a minute. Ethan, tell me your name.
Say Ethan.
Hey, Ethan. Hey, tell Becky what your name is.
You forgot about the solids,
but
I made that too.
Say cheese.
Okay, Jessica, you go.
My name is Kelly.
Kelly?
Hey, y'all do it right.
My name is Jessica.
And what's this little black-haired girl's name over here?
Lisa!
And are you all ready for Christmas?
Yeah!
Is Santa Claus Ethan coming to see you?
Ethan!
No! Yes!
Let's get it. Ooh!
Bye, buddy.
And he sits all alone by himself.
Let's go outside, Jessica.
Boss, I'm the boss.
Hey, y'all watch
yes.
for it. Watch for it.
Let's go open one of our presents.
Okay.
Yeah.
Can we go?
No.
Let's go outside.
Tell Becky.
Tell Becky. Say, look at Becky and say, ho, ho, ho.
Look around. At Becky. See over there?
Look around this way.
What does Santa say?
Tell Becky.
What does he say?
Tell Becky.
What does Santa say?
Let's go on here. Let's go on here.
What is that?
What?
It's a cottontail, isn't it?
But
it comes from a rabbit.
It comes from a rabbit.
What are you glad
for?
I don't know.
For what?
Mm-hmm. Let's put it up here. Turn around.
What's this?
What do you think it is?
I don't know.
It's Santa's hat, isn't it?
You think Santa's head's going to be cold when he comes in his sleigh?
Oh.
You think so?
I got his hat.
Where's the rest of him?
I don't know.
Where's his beard?
What's here?
Mm-hmm.
What's here? Okay, just look like a thing yet.
Oh, really? He carries those cushions around and looks like he's Santa Claus.
Oh.
And they're full of toys.
Uh-huh. Is that what you do?
What is this, your cushion?
Is that it?
It's
a Santa Claus bag.
Oh, what is this?
Look at the toys in there.
Let me look in your sack. Can I also look in your sack, Santa Claus?
Yeah.
Let me open it and see what's in there.
That's a cute picture.
Is there a train down in there?
Yeah.
Are there some cars in there?
Yeah.
Yeah, and some little baby dolls?
No, I don't like baby dolls. Where are they?
Let's see. You see a train down there?
I see
them
right here.
Oh, is that it right there?
No, there's nothing in that tank.
Okay.
That
might be an alligator.
Up on the roof.
Yeah.
Can't you hear those footprints up there, Mike?
Say you see it.
Move. I'm going down to check for Google. I heard something down there. Okay, deal.
Then I got into John McClure and Stand Back and all that stuff. I was extremely well read.
You might as well be taking still shots.
Are you on it?
Yeah. These are the nursing students.
Students.
These are the student nurses in our family. No other ones over here.
That's true. This year, nursing. She's an LPN. She's going to really expect it. I think she starts next semester.
Why are they watching so diligently? Look at it.
You can go off over it, right?
Yeah. I bet he stuck what he's doing now.
Cartoons. Are they good?
Yes. They're very good.
Wayman, do I see a nod of the head acknowledging agreement?
Never seen that. I see a walleye.
She told me it was a pipe fairy. They got out of school yesterday. I was back there welding. They knocked on the door, you know. Hot fairy come out here.
So this is the biggest fairy they can find, right?
I guess.
They thought it was Mac. But we got him!
Oh, you got perfect
Look, man, we were out there for 25 minutes. Y'all never did find it. Y'all were together.
This is jealousy. Right on top of
Daniel. Y'all went there and right on top of Daniel's face.
I'll tell that was God in it.
I want to hear Daniel talk.
Hello.
Let's hear the deep voice.
Hi. Hi. I'm Brent.
Oh, crazy.
I think you glasses on.
Get them!
No.
Get them!
Get up here, Jenna. Get up. Jenna's dying. Get up here.
Get this one here that doesn't have any lights at all. Scrooge!
Hey.
Scrooge!
That's Scrooge's house.
Yeah.
Look at that Santa Claus. Look! Look at the wreaths!
Ooh, look!
Mom, get that house over there.
I did.
Gotta get that. Oh, look at over there.
Blue.
Oh, cool, man. Look over here.
God, wait a minute.
Did you get it all at this
house? I don't know what I'm getting.
Can't you see it?
Yeah.
Well, it's gonna get whatever you see.
Oh, cool! Look, a little train.
That's
Santa Claus is in it too.
No, that's afraid it's a snow. That's
insane. I know.
It said
that. Look, they went all the way across.
Get the train.
I got the train.
Here's the
way
front.
It looks like it's moving back.
One changes colors.
Where?
The blue house. It just went blue. It was red.
Oh,
What'd he get, Becky?
How do you think they do that?
Oh, Becky, how did you do that?
Look!
Oh, wow.
It changes red white.
It does?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Does that tree change color?
Yes, watch. Red. You, 102. See, it turned blue.
You, 102.
Gary, what were you watching?
Movie.
What was the old movie?
The Good One. Burt Lancaster.
Gary, I'm talking to you.
What's the name
movie
of the movie?
Were you watching?
I don't know the name of it.
It's
Apache? Or something like that?
Yeah.
This is so fun.
I know.
The macho movie.
Oh.
Drags a woman around.
It must be pretty good down there.
What, Becky?
I can hear them screaming. Gertrude brought these flowers in this vase. And she brought the vase and the flowers on the table in there. And she brought this package. And now me and Woody and Mom get to choose which one we want. So we're going to fight over.
How about two people at a time?
Okay.
The haunted house.
Okay, come one person.
In the basement.
Your wife won't go with you.
Walk this you way. This is the psychiatric ward. In my mansion.
Double dark.
Come on down, please. Here's dear Katie. She got in a fight with one of our other patients. Oh, look! She's departing from us right now.
There she goes.
Oh, well. Walk this way, please. Is anyone hungry?
We
have today's special. Is anyone hungry?
Head of lamb.
Here we go. Ah, he's back, Igor. Did you see that?
No.
All right, come on. Try that again. Back, Igor!
Oh.
Oh, look at this big head. Isn't that nice and juicy?
Yummy, yummy.
Oh. Walk this way. Please try to stay on the bridge. We wouldn't want a tragic accident. My pets are dying to meet you. Please try to stay on the bridge. Walk this way. Oh, look. Katie has departed. And that concludes our tour.
See, we're having a very educational conversation here on the night of December the 23rd, 1990. A very intellectual conversation.
Tell him what our Sunday school teacher said today about the different things that you want. You want a bigger swimming pool than you have.
I'll let you
and
tell
she
it.
Just named all these things. Oh, you tell it. Tell it.
We don't have a swimming pool, so we just want the first one.
No, it was just say, I want it. You get one thing and you want something else. I want this and I want that. And she named everything.
Wow, wow, wow.
But she didn't name the hot tub or the hot house. Or she didn't name...
Hot house?
See, all these years I've been wanting a hot house or a hot tub or a swimming pool.
A hot house?
Christmas. He pays no attention. He does.
He thought you said.
No, I did.
Well, you, so he's been there every get,
time. The thing about it, you get one, and about 6 or 8 months, you're tired of the thing. You don't know what to do with it. You think, well, I just got to go in there and get in that tub there. I got all this money in it. And so, if you don't have it, you don't have to worry about those
don't
things.
Don't have to feel guilty for not using it.
And most people that have them, after a year or so, they don't use them at all.
That's true. The lesson, though, was about they had gone around and asked several people.
Why do you talk so loud when I got the camera on?
What their American dream was, is. And in asking them what their American dream is, none of them said anything that was about the
morals.
The quality of life. It was all about the quantity of life. And that was when they got into, they wanted a swimming pool, or they wanted a nice house in a prestigious neighborhood.
But that's what, that's the American way. That's what we're taught.
Yeah, I'm uncomfortable. I learned that.
Walk back there and see what they're doing.
I mean, well, join this intellectual conversation.
What are you doing?
I'm afraid they're make sure that, be sure your glasses are up out.
But what I wanted to say when she was talking about that, about all these things people want, they want this. I can't even name all of the things, but it was so true. It was, want a trip, want to go on a big trip.
And I get
I want to be able to go to, be in the club that you go to this place in New York and
Cassie,
wear the greatest.
Did you put Christmas presents under the bed? Because they're crawling under the bed.
No,
you said don't move the suitcase because there's stuff under there.
There's your old calendars and stuff under there.
Oh, they're probably all mashed in.
That's why I wanted you to go back there and settle them down slightly.
But the only thing, if you, like I want to say, if she'd have given me a chance, I'd have entered into the discussion, but she didn't. But anyway, I was going to say, well, if you don't have something sort of to make plans for, you know, what is life?
But you're supposed to make plans for the hereafter by living your life in the way that
I am.
He would want you to live your life.
I am.
And he wants you to have a swimming pool or a hot tub or a hot house, doesn't he?
Yes, he did.
He wants you to want to have those and then to be strong enough that you'll have the strength to resist the temptations of buying it. Because I know that when we first, Daddy's one time asked me, now if we have a good season, and I've told this a lot of times, if we have a good season, says, we'll buy you a bicycle in the fall when tomato canning was over, you know. Well, that fall came along, and he said, I tell you, boys, a lot of work around the bicycle. I said, if you wait along to next year, maybe we can get you a small motorcycle. So, of course, that pleased us. We went on next year, and that fall came along, and they said, well, so now you're learning to drive. And said, maybe if we wait another year, we could get you a car. Well, I always wanted a bicycle. And when we got on up and got married and all, and the war was coming along, and so we ordered 2 bicycles, Connie and I, one. Well, they had the boys, but they didn't have the girls, and so they shipped that
from
to
Spiegel,
me.
From Spiegel, that's where we are.
And what I did then is, I was riding that thing over to shopping back. And the funny thing to me, it was uphill both ways. So, I was standing up here one day, and this black boy came up from a drugstore, and he's supposed to go, oh, Miss Stedham's, and he came up here, you know. And I said, if he can ride up this hill, I'll be able to do it. And the next time I rode out like that and came back, and I pulled a lead in my leg, and I hopping around there. And so I went over, the next day was when I went over there and rode my bicycle, and Connie would go by and wave at me.
Now that he had it there.
Yeah, I was pedaling that thing, and they were giving me two gallons more gas a week, wasn't left. You didn't have a 2 gallons gas
a week. See, your gas was right.
Since I was in defense work, they gave me, you know, $2 worth is what it was there. We'd have that much gas a week there. And so one of the boys when I was over the next day, went down to the shop there, and one of them asked me, said, would you sell that bicycle? And I said, yeah. And he said, well, what did you take for it? And I said, I paid $35 for it, and I'll take $35 for it. He said, I'll buy it from you then. So I took his $35 and went up and called Connie and told her that night to come and get me.
Oh, and that's $35, that was an expensive bicycle.
That was
1941,
I guess.
I told him, after that, I said, the fun in that was wanting it. But after I got it, it wasn't fun anymore. It was work.
Holly, you're not in their family. Not now.
Sure she is.
Give them our present.
Open the gate.
Kate.
Whoa. The present.
The big mama.
I have no idea what that is. I do. That's what they
want. I bought it. I do. Is Katie?
I don't.
Yeah.
I told
you. You can tear up that bag.
I have to. I can't open it anyway.
Hey, Bob. What? They're opening their presents from each other.
That big one right there is wooden. Oh, no, I know what it is. That sling. Thank
and
you.
Right, mine is in a heavy red box. Do you want to get it where you can get it out from around? You can't get into it.
That big one, square one, on four.
Oh,
what's that for your doll?
Yeah.
How darn.
She'll probably try to sit in it and she'll break it. And
how cute. Where
you have to paint it
like
or
that?
Finish it or something.
Don't have
the
to.
The flea market.
Mm-hmm. Well, she might want to. She had another one from us, too.
Oh, doesn't it smell good? Now, see, Gary, you could make something like that if you get your lazy
what
self
are you looking
together.
For,
Did you hear me, Gary?
He's trying to ignore you.
He does. He ignores me all the time.
There.
Very good.
Thank you.
Mom and Dad,
she's
not
doll
helping
Kristen.
Now.
She's only opening the ones from us. The only ones that were open.
Think she'll like it?
You want to go in there and get my rabbit and put in it?
Get mine, Kelly.
Where's
that's
Becky
the one
sitting?
From us.
I'll sit over there next to him. Wow, that looks fun. That's on the
yes.
chair right there.
Yes.
Am I getting yes. out the presents?
Woody.
But you don't know what's from us, do you?
Well, she found this
okay.
to her and found this that to Brent. Is that all?
Well, there's
yeah.
presents to you and
let's see, Brent.
Yeah, that's right.
Cast traded set.
Oh, what is it? Oh, how nice. Do you have anything like that? See, you didn't need any. To go
this
to
is from
mom.
Kelly and Brent.
Brent, is, my,
is
mine a
you?
Framed picture of Michael
that's
and
Becky's.
Excuse me, can I come back?
That's the Gary.
Yes, go ahead.
This is a heavy one.
Oh,
cool.
Thank you.
And it must be a book because it can still some.
What's that? Oh, it's a pie holder, right?
No.
No?
It's bracelets. You can make bracelets with them.
Great.
It's got instructions inside.
Oh,
now
I found that last summer.
Oh, you are.
Thank you again.
Yeah.
I think that's everything, right?
It's one from Brent,
oh,
one from Paris.
No, Becky's got another one. No,
she didn't get very far.
Oh, here's
thank
Kelly.
You.
I got two.
Yeah,
did Kelly were. Open hers yet?
No.
Open it.
Is it something good?
How about Gary? Oh, did he get
what do you want?
Mm-hmm.
Open.
I was trying to tape.
Merry Christmas.
Ah, it's a fur coat cake.
You got a what? A fur coat?
A fur no, it's cake. Probably a fruit cake.
Fruitcake. Oh, y'all gave
homemade fruitcake.
Mm.
Oh, maybe not.
What? Oh, I'm sorry. I opened the
what could it be?
I don't know. Kelly, you're throwing away. You don't want to know what that is?
I hope it
it's fits. Candy! Oh.
Well, what's in the box,
it,
Kelly?
I hope they fit.
What is it?
They're slabs.
It's a rabbit. It's
bubble gum machine.
I knew that.
You knew that?
Okay, sort of a linen.
Hey, get the camera back over here, Mrs.
Oh, yeah, let's see, Kim. What is it? How cute.
Those are pretty, Gertrude.
She got petite, she's saying. They're petite.
What is it?
They're petite.
Petite, Nate.
It's
going to
be funny.
It's a frame.
Hold it up. Let's see.
It's a frame of Pollyanna. There's a little boy that Brent said he's too Disney.
they didn't have the parent draft, so I had to settle for it. That's the original poster from the movie.
You're kidding! Where did you get it?
MGM Studios.
And you know, that could be really valuable someday. That'll be
a cool thing. I was about to say you brought it back on the plane, but you didn't.
Yeah, that's great!
I framed it myself.
It's yours!
Did you frame it yourself?
Yeah.
And I know how much frames for.
Thank you.
The all the ones in
there. How do you? Get the
Kelly. That is so neat. I'm gonna have to take my doll away from Kelly.
Well,
seven
I know.
Eyeball fixed.
I don't look want to stick that up on the wall. But
how much does it take,
people
Mom?
People are afraid hanging stuff. A peasant?
Yeah.
That's a peasant.
Oh, thank you.
Look familiar.
You have a peasant cowboy to sit on your.
That's pretty. I like that too.
I don't know. Do you have any place you can put that
of
that
course.
You won't be embarrassed?
Oh, well, I won't be embarrassed.
Right out
it's
of my
neat.
Old papers, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. Old newspaper.
I'll do that.
Paper mache.
Yeah.
Lovely.
Try it on. Try it on.
I bet you Isabella, isn't it pretty?
I know. That's what I thought, too.
I've forgotten about it.
And you got appreciate
you
got
it.
You
bought it.
You
didn't find anything.
I didn't make her an apple.
Try it on, Beck.
I don't know. Should we let Kelly go ahead and open it?
Yeah, I guess so. But
yay!
I think it's going to have to put the
and it's pretty.
Oh,
whoever's hungry and wants some bubble gum.
This is me.
It's a pillow.
I mean, you were surprised when you saw it.
Look on
it.
They said they were. Well, where did they get them? They were just ones they printed and never did.
Hold it up. For the camera.
Store of
smile.
Here.
I have a new pillow.
Aww.
Is it mushy?
Yep.
She loves pillows.
Yeah, Megan said one time she likes fancy things on her bed. Brown.
What you see is what it's going to look like on TV. So you want to keep her centered.
Oops. Put one on her front.
Put one over her mouth, Kelly.
Yeah, put one over her mouth.
It'll have to be it'll have to be a real big one.
Okay.
Here.
Okay,
talk.
I got
bugs on my mouth. My Christmas present.
But like I said, I thought I looked pretty good when I came here today.
Brent, will you
this one always my
morning. Oh, boy.
That's the best Christmas present a little girl.
Brent, well, it was her grandmother. Bless her heart. She said that's the best Christmas present any little girl could have, her grandmother. next Christmas, you're going to be so big that I'm not going to be able to hold you.
How much do they charge an hour for decorating?
That's going to be big.
You're doing it on purpose.
Give it up. Okay,
y'all. Not yet. Wait a minute. I don't have my camera fixed.
I can't.
Just a minute.
What are you doing?
I'm winding it to where I left off. Okay, it's getting there now. Wait a minute. Wait.
Okay, y'all sing.
Wait, not yet.
Please go tell us when.
Girl, the Lord is come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare Him with. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and nature.
Mom has.
Okay, I'm going to sing it high.
On the midnight clear, that glorious song of hope from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men from him, all gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing.
Try. I can't carry it.
Oh, she. Okay, hurry.
Wait.
For a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay. The little Lord Jesus.
Oh, I can't stop.
Oh.
Oh, little town of Bethlehem. I have that band of
them.
Yes.
Oh, yeah. Well.
Can you play it?
I don't know, I try.
It is. Yeah.
Harry's gonna run.
Dorothy, dear, it's Aunt Em, darling.
Oh, Auntie Em, it's you.
Yes, darling.
Hello there. Anybody home? I just dropped by because I heard the little girl got caught in the big... Well, she seems all right now.
Yeah, she got quite a bump on the head. We kind of thought there for a minute she was going to leave us.
Oh.
But I did leave you, Uncle Henry. That's just the trouble. And I tried to get back for days and days.
There, lie quiet now. You just had a bad dream.
Sure. Remember me?
Your old pal, Hunk? Oh.
Me? Hickory? You couldn't forget my face, could you?
But it wasn't a dream. It was a place. And you, and you, and you, and you were there.
Oh, sure.
But you couldn't have been, could you?
Oh, we dream lots of silly things when we...
No, Aunt Em. This was a real, truly live place. And I remember that some of it wasn't very nice, but most of it was beautiful. But just the same, all I kept saying to everybody was, I want to go home. And they sent me home. Doesn't anybody believe me?
Of course we believe you, Dorothy.
Oh, but anyway, Toto, we're home. Home. And this is my room. And you're all here. And I'm not going to leave here ever, ever again. Because I love you all. And, oh, Auntie Em, there's no place like home.